As we allege, the 70 defendants charged today allegedly demanded over $2 million in bribe money from contractors in exchange for giving out over $13 million of work on NYCHA buildings. And if the contractors didn't pay up, the defendants wouldn't give them the work. That's classic pay to play. And this culture of corruption at NYCHA ends today.
Dozens of current and former employees of the New York City Housing Authority are facing federal bribery charges following an investigation by the Department of Justice. Now, according to Damian Williams, the gentleman you heard in that video, and the US attorney for the Southern District of New York, the 70 individuals caught up in the scandal makes this the largest number of federal bribery charges the DOJ has handed out in a single day, in just one day. Now, dozens of employees, including superintendents and assistant superintendents, had taken more than $2 million in bribes from contractors seeking to do work at apartment buildings throughout the city's five boroughs, from Stapleton Houses on Staten Island to Eastchester Gardens in the Bronx. More than 300,000 working class New Yorkers depend on the city's public housing system. Hundreds of thousands of more people are currently on waiting lists, just hoping to snag a unit, an apartment in one of the buildings. As the nation's largest public housing authority, NYCHA receives $1.5 billion in federal funding. The agency is run by a board of seven people appointed by the mayor. But properties that fall under the management of the NYC Housing Authority are in need of a whopping $78 billion in repairs, which is what makes this story of corruption and abuse just so disgusting, so depressing. Tenants have been complaining about the dire conditions of aging buildings, which have been riddled with leaky pipes, malfunctioning elevators, and rodent infestations. So, what are the 70 current and former employees of this agency accused of doing exactly? What are the specific details? Well, prosecutors allege that the scheme involved deals with vendors for building repairs that cost less than $10,000. These deals do not have to go through a competitive bidding process. And the reason for that is so that building managers or superintendents can address necessary repairs quickly without dealing with a bidding process. But this also, unfortunately, left a lot of room for abuse, as the feds are alleging in their charges. Now, more than $13 million in work, however, was wrongly handed out, prosecutors said, with defendants demanding payment to authorize work, meaning bribes, or approve it after it was done. The accused employees usually received kickbacks of 10 to 20% of the contract value, prosecutors said, though sometimes the payments were even higher. The 476-page complaint by the federal prosecutors provides very specific examples of criminal wrongdoing. Like at the Vladeck houses on Manhattan's Lower East Side, where an assistant superintendent basically engaged in a shakedown in order to get a contract approved. So there were messages that the DOJ reviewed as a part of their investigation. Here's an example of it. "You need to take care of me," the assistant superintendent said, according to the complaint. Soon thereafter, the contractor paid him $1,000 in cash in the basement of one of the development's buildings. The DOJ filing also details stunning allegations against assistant supervisor Joseph Fuller from the Seth Lowe houses in Brooklyn. Apparently, Fuller wasn't satisfied with the kickbacks, the illegal kickbacks he was getting, and wanted to double the amount. So in 2021, he told a contractor that the standard 10% kickback of the contract value just wasn't enough, and that he would be raising the rate up to 20%. The contractor wasn't amused and did not get any more work at that property after refusing to pay the increased kickback amount. Look, this is a classic pay-to-play scheme. In New York City, close to 100 different buildings were impacted by it. Suspect Juan Mercado, a residential building super, solicited and accepted a total of at least approximately 340 $14,300 in bribes in exchange for arranging for certain contractors to receive no-bid contracts from the agency worth a total of at least approximately $1.7 million, the Fed said. In addition to the corruption, the DOJ's complaint also details how one defendant attempted to destroy evidence by doing a factory reset of her phone to avoid turning over text messages to federal investigators. I gotta pause on this for a second. I don't know if she knows this, but your text messages get recorded by the company that provides your cell service. Like, they have that on file for a certain number of months, possibly years, depending on which company your cell phone provider is. I mean, it's just how stupid can you possibly be? Anyway, according to the New York Times, NYCHA's chief executive, Lisa Bova Hyatt, had alerted investigators to the suspicious behavior behind some of the charges. She also accused the defendants of putting their greed first and violating the trust of our residents, their fellow NYCHA colleagues, and all New Yorkers. Bova Hyatt also says that the agency won't allow bad actors to undermine their achievements. But even before this scandal was unearthed, NYCHA was plagued with all sorts of issues, including the submission of false paperwork to the federal government, indicating that they had conducted inspections of lead paint in apartments. Those inspections never took place at all. And in 2019, as part of a settlement with federal prosecutors, the city accepted the appointment of a federal monitor to scrutinize NYCHA's progress, dealing with some of its most serious problems, including lead, mold, and heating failures. Also back in 2019, an investigative report by a publication called The City found that low-level managers of developments had handed out $250 million in contracts to a small group of vendors. In September of 2021, 9 contractors were indicted on bribery charges in connection with micro-purchasing schemes. As a result of this agency's corruption and the crime-ridden past that we're dealing with here, some of the residents of these properties are absolutely unsurprised by the additional criminal charges reported this week. That's how housing works, said Michael Jones, 37 years old, a tenant in the Robert Fulton houses in Chelsea, which was one of the developments named in the scheme on Tuesday. It's all about money. The people running it always want to get a kickback. So look, I'm glad that there are consequences here, and I'm glad the DOJ is doing its job. But what are the possible solutions? Remember, we're talking about a government agency here. We're not talking about a private company. We're not even talking about a nonprofit. Well, Jocelyn Strauber, the city's investigations commissioner, said on Tuesday that her agency had suggested to NYCHA officials that they make reforms to the micro-purchasing process, noting that misconduct around these smaller repairs drove up the cost of this type of work and diverted valuable public funds away from public housing and into the pockets of corrupt NYCHA staff. But generally speaking, there needs to be way more oversight of this agency and possibly yearly audits of how these public funds are being used and whether repair contracts are riddled with inflated prices. Because seriously, consider how much these pay-to-play schemes result in government waste, meaning the government wasting your money. So if agency employees are getting 20% kickbacks, that means the contractors that they're awarding contracts to are going to inflate the cost of the repairs that they're conducting in order to provide the funds for the kickback. In other words, they're stealing from you, the taxpayer. And luckily, there are some oversight steps that the Justice Department has proposed that NYCHA luckily has agreed to implement.
Our recommendations include transferring responsibility for micro purchases from development level staff to a centralized procurement unit with necessary expertise, standardizing micro purchase costs by establishing a cost schedule for typical services with excess costs to be explained in writing by the vendor and approved in writing prior to the commencement of the work by the neighborhood administrator who manages staff at several developments, requiring review by NYCHA staff outside the development of documentation of completed work for all micro purchases prior to processing payments to vendors, And I want to note that the three recommendations that I just mentioned were previously made to NYCHA and ultimately were not implemented. And like I said, NYCHA has committed to implement the recommendations that we are issuing today.
Now, I hope that there is increased oversight, and let's do a follow up to make sure that these proposals are in fact being implemented by NYCHA. But there is a possibility that public employees will no longer manage these buildings in the future, and instead will have the private sector do so. Look, as the New York Times reports, a plan to shift some developments over to private management and to run others under a new public benefit corporation could unlock billions of dollars from a new stream of federal housing aid. But honestly, I really fail to understand how switching over to private companies would make the situation any better. Much of municipal services in Los Angeles, for instance, have been outsourced to private nonprofits, and it's been a disaster. There's been a great deal of waste and even less oversight. When it comes to housing providers alone, there are 1,486 housing providers and shelters in the greater Los Angeles metro area. Combined, these Los Angeles metro housing providers and shelters employ 10,597 people, earn more than $2 billion in revenue each year, earn is a very strong word, and have assets of $7 billion. And there seems to be a new scandal with these nonprofits every month. I'll give you the latest. Just last month, a worker associated with the nonprofit Urban Alchemy was fired after video emerged showing him spraying a hose just inches away from a homeless person who was scrambling to collect his belongings and get away in order to avoid getting wet. The video was just absolutely disgusting, absolutely horrendous, disgusting. And considering how much money LA spends on, you know, nonprofits that are supposed to help alleviate homelessness, you should keep in mind that homelessness has obviously exploded in LA County, and we keep hearing about these scandals. So again, simply switching over to the private sector really won't help without adequate accountability and oversight. And I'm worried that we're going to learn all the wrong lessons from the outcome of the DOJ's investigations into NYCHA. And I want to end this segment with a comment from one of our viewers, one of our members actually. You can become a member by going to tyt.com/join. Miss Anonymous says, Anna, I live in affordable housing. It's not really affordable and corporations don't fix anything. A corporation took over my complex, raised the rent for repairs, but didn't fix anything. And so that's a private company coming in to manage the building. And obviously there are issues with that as well. So at the end of the day, if there's no accountability, if there's no oversight, abuse will take place. And it appears that's what happened here, when they decided to take advantage of the lack of regulations pertaining to lower cost repairs for these buildings. They didn't have to deal with the no bid, they didn't have to deal with bidding for contracts. They were able to award contracts to their preferred contractors or vendors. And as a result, they took bribes, they engaged in corruption, and they collected kickbacks. Again, really, really happy that the DOJ was investigating this and has taken action. And they say that more arrests are to come. But it is absolutely disgusting that people were willing to do this to the detriment of working class people who rely on the affordable housing, as affordable as it can be in New York City.
If you enjoy this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.